and welcome to Tune Into Wellness Today. My name is Lisa Marie Tersini. I am the owner and founder of a company called Inspiring Wellness Solutions. I am also the host and founder of today's show, Tune Into Wellness Today. Tune Into Wellness Today was developed to bring to you, the residents of the Capital Region and surrounding areas, a host and a variety of wellness services, programs, and modalities. Today, I'm happy to say I have three guests on my show. They'll be speaking about their services. And my first guest is Lisa Cartier from Life Cycles in Balance. And Lisa is a doula and an emissary of fertility and wellness, as well as someone that supports people in the fertility field who are needing emotional and physical support. She's a Reiki master and teacher, and just a woman who's filled with a lot of love to help people succeed. Welcome, Lisa.
Thank you.
It's nice to have you
here. Thank you very much.
So, Life Cycles and Balance, and the work that you do is to help people who have challenges in that area of fertility. Is that correct?
Yes, it is.
Okay. Which is a fabulous field to be in.
Yes.
Because there are so many people who have challenges and need that extra kind of support, that emotional support, as well as the physical support.
Yes.
Lisa, tell us what your program actually is and what it is that you do, if you would, please.
Okay. First of all, assess what is actually going on in their bodies. I have a very large intake form that we look at every different aspect of their lives, their lifestyle choices, what physically is going on with them, what their dietary situations are. And then from that, we put together a program that will address each of the needs that they are having in their bodies at the time. A lot of women have polycystic ovarian syndrome or endometriosis, which lead to fertility issues. And through different support issues, dietary supplements, energy work, changes in lifestyles, we can address them and help them to conceive.
So it is a very much a bio-individual program,
yes,
then, depending on what that couple or that particularly that woman is going through and what's going on in her body.
It's
at
very
that
individual
particular time.
Yes.
And if I'm hearing you and understanding you correctly, then it's a variety of modality and services,
yes,
not just one focus.
Yes.
Please tell me a little bit about the energy work that you're doing to help, you know, that woman.
Well, I practice energy medicine, which works with the meridians and all the different energy systems in the body, balancing those with fertility. The kidney meridians need to be balanced, as well as spleen energy, so we would work with that. Also, with the Reiki, is very helpful for unblocking, you know, blockages that develop in the body. And every time there's an issue with any type of illness or issue, endometriosis, polycystic ovarian syndrome, there's always a reason that that energy is staying there and they are not able to conceive. So we work with whatever individually is going on with them and help to move out the blockages.
Now, you are a doula, and for those that are watching this show that do not actually know what that means, would you explain what a doula is,
yes,
and what your function is, please?
Okay, a birth doula is a woman that supports the woman throughout their pregnancy and is with them through their labor and delivery. In most cultures, women have other women with them. In our culture, we don't generally do that. So the doula is actually a Greek word that stands for women to women. So we stay with them, we give them education, we help during the labor to make it a little easier for them. We support them whether they're having a medical birth or a natural birth, and just to help them, guide them, direct them what to do next, what can we do to help, you know, the situation with the pain or whatever the issue is, and then emotionally support them.
It's really beautiful. You know, I recall reading a book many years ago, and I think the book was called The Red Tent. It was that long ago. And they speak, one part of that book was where women during menstruation period time would all come together and they'd sit in this tent. Are you familiar with it?
Yes.
And they would menstruate on straw. But the important part of that was that they had that support of other women during that time.
Exactly.
you know, and then when their time was up, right, then they would help support other. It's a beautiful, beautiful service that we in our culture certainly do not seem to have. So I love that you're doing that. What is one of the biggest challenges you feel your clients have when they come to see you?
Fertility-wise? Okay, correct. Most of the women that I work with are being told that their ovaries are not functioning properly. And these women are in their 20s and 30s. And what I am finding most often is that they've been either put on the pill at a very early age or have been on it for 10, 15, 20 years, which actually creates an issue where your ovaries go to sleep. So they're not able to conceive. And one of the biggest problems now is they're putting young girls on birth control pills at 14, and their bodies have not had time to adjust to what their cycle should be. We actually need 3 years for that to be accomplished.
Okay.
So if they've been put on the pill before that age, or before those 3 years have gone by, their body doesn't even know how to adjust to that. It's never done it. So the ovaries start to not function properly.
Wow, very interesting. Yes. When they come to see you under those circumstances, mm-hmm. do you then have them come off of the birth control?
Absolutely.
As the first line of,
yes.
of work that you do?
Yes.
Okay. It's beautiful. I mean, mm-hmm. it's that's a beautiful thing. How successful is your program with these types of issues?
Well, if someone will commit to working with me for a minimum of 3 months, then I have 100% success. I generally ask them to commit to 3 to 6 months. It takes 3 months for your ovaries to produce a healthy egg. So we need at least 3 months to get a new generation of healthy eggs and get the body back into alignment. 6 months is better. Sometimes, you know, if they don't have a lot of issues physically, a lot of what needs to be done is stress reduction, because they are very, very stressed, and the more they go through the fertility process, the more stressed they become.
So you are seeing women as young as mid-20s that are having fertility
yes.
issues.
And they're being told their ovaries don't work.
So they're believing at such a very young age they're not going to have a child,
yes.
they're not going to give birth to a
mm-hmm.
child. That is shocking. To
yes.
me, that's very, very shocking to me and sad at the same time. When someone comes to see you and they commit to the 3 to 6 months, what are you doing? And I know it's a bio-individual
mm-hmm.
program, to use my terms, but what is it that you're doing? How frequently every month are they coming in?
I see them twice a month.
Twice a month.
And
okay.
I give them work to do when they go home. We set up a specific plan.
Okay.
I have a book of affirmations that I've written. I give that to them and ask them to do one a day. I ask them to do a gratitude journal to try to get their mindset into a different place, first of all,
mm-hmm.
because they've been so focused on not being able to conceive that it totally takes over their life. So I try to get them into a place where they have something that they can be thankful and grateful for so that we can start bringing those energies down.
Beautiful.
And then we would work specifically with different nutritional protocols, different lifestyle changes. You know, what are the toxins that are in their home? What can we change? What can we do differently? Exercise is very important. And again, it's individual, but a lot of it's nutritional. And different. I give them different recipes. I give them quite a bit of homework to do
mm-hmm.
because it really is a lifestyle change.
Of course.
Which is what's different with the medical model of IVF and IUI. They're basically taking your body and putting it into menopause and then forcing it to do something without fixing whatever is happening.
You know, I know a young lady who has been trying to conceive for many years who has been told several times by her medical physician that
mm-hmm.
she has old ovaries.
Exactly.
So I think she might be a great candidate for
yes.
me to reach out to you and have more conversation
awesome.
About,
mm-hmm.
Because it is incredibly heartbreaking for women
mm-hmm.
who really want to have children to be told that
right.
they cannot do that. So to me, as listening to you, the biggest benefit someone would receive or potentially receive from treating with you is to conceive a child, a healthy child,
yes.
and to give delivery to
mm-hmm.
a healthy child or multiple children, correct?
Right.
What's one or two extra benefit? Well, I guess stress reduction is
another
one.
Stress reduction is huge. And the really awesome thing I think about what I do also is being a birth doula. Oftentimes when they conceive, I get to be with them through their pregnancy. So at that point, I end up, by the time delivery comes, I've had almost a 2-year relationship with them, which is very cool.
It is beautiful, and I know that you have a cesarean section to go to in a little bit, mm-hmm. and in a circumstance like that where it's a medical model, mm-hmm. and you'll be participating at the hospital, what is your role in that environment?
Answering questions, helping the mom to stay calm and the dad, supporting them in the operating room if I'm allowed to go in. Sometimes I am, sometimes I'm not.
Okay.
And also to be with them postpartum, helping her with breastfeeding, especially since she's had surgery, it's a little more of a challenge. So to be with them a lot for support and answering questions and just helping them get started, so that since this was a major change, I mean, this woman is a month early, so there's a lot of stuff that she hasn't, you know, acclimated to yet.
Okay.
So emotional support afterwards is going to be very critical.
Lisa, it's beautiful. Thank you so very much
you.
For doing this work. I just think it's amazing.
Yes,
thank you.
I love it.
If you would like more information on Lisa and the work she does, go online to lisacartier.com.